Building time. Building time. Who will win and who will fall? Find out when we burn the wall. It's building time.
Hello, this is Stampy, and welcome to Building Time, the series where Squid and I need to build in time.
Yay! Woo! Hi, Stamps.
Already drinking the old swiftness potions, are we, Squid? You want to win this week.
Brian, early in the morning, I'm ready to go. I'm ready to win. Anyway, speaking of winning, who won in the last episode?
Ah, well, the producer is just about to hand me my notes. Here we go. I have the votes in front of me, and they are as follows. Stampy Cat got 156,000 votes.
Woo!
Squid Nugget got
184,000
votes, which means you are the winner! And the pig over here got...
How many did he get?
Where is he? Here he is. The pig got 25,000 votes.
No way.
25,000 people voted for the pig.
That is unbelievable. That is unbelievable.
I think we should give the pig a special prize. So there we go. No, the golden carrot. The golden carrot award goes to the pig.
Right, well, I'm going to put another one on top of my little party. And there we go. It's not looking too bad now.
Make a little pattern here. Made a little pattern. Yeah. It's pretty close. So wait, you're 1, 2, 3, 4 for Squid Nugget. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You weren't lying, Squid. And 6 for me. So only 2 in it. Only 2 in it. After 10. Well, this is the 11th. But after 10 goes, it's only 2 in it. So very close so far.
Not too bad, Stamps. Right.
And we are ready. Yeah, we're ready. We've got a new topic which has been randomly selected from the comments of last week's episode. And shall we jump straight into it, Squid?
Messing? I think the pig should do it.
Okay. So we're just
want to call him over
for the pig. Oh, see, look, since he won that golden carrot award, it's gone to his head. He won't even help out now.
Stamps.
No, look at him. He's turning his snout. He won't even come and help us out just because he's won some awards. Ridiculous.
Do you want to do it? I think I did it last episode, so I'll let you do the honors for today's building time.
We are building a dog park, and that was suggested by Insane Bolt 2.
A dog park.
So that would be a park for dogs. That would be Squid.
A dog park, Stamps. I'm not sure.
Right. No. No time to think, Squid. We are going straight into it. Okay.
Okay.
We're gonna have to. Right. So we will begin in
three, two, one.
Go. Right. So I have muted Squid Nugget. And now I have 15 minutes, which has started, to build a dog park. Okay, so I want this to be the best dog park in the world, but I need a twist. I need some sort of twist on it to make it some sort of special dog park. I could do like a doggy bone hunt, maybe. Maybe I could hide bones under the ground, and then the dogs need to try and find them. That might be a fun thing to do. And I can have an area where you can go and walk your dogs. Maybe like a dog training area and a doggy pond as well. So yeah, I guess that's what I'm going to do. So I'm going to start off, I think, by building a statue of a dog. And this might end well and it might not. So I am going to build the best dog in the world. And that is, of course, Barnaby. And I'm going to build that in the center of this area here. So what I'm going to do... So I'm going to go and I'm going to build kind of like a plinth, a little platform in the very middle here. So the very center of my dog park is going to be a statue of Barnaby, which is going to be in the middle here. I don't want it to be too big, though. One, because I don't want to spend too much time building it and running out of time like I did with my hotel, which is why I lost. And also, I want to have plenty of room to add lots of the other things around the outside as well. So I think this should be a perfect size. So let's see if I can make a dog that kind of fits into this area here. So here are the dog legs. I guess I can break away the side there, and then here can be the hind legs, I guess. I think it looks a little bit too square. Let's go back a little bit further and do the back legs here, and now I can go and do the body. I should probably get some dogs. I know what I could do. If I spawn in loads of dogs now and tame them, that means it'll be the limit of how many dogs you can have in the world, and then that means Squid won't be able to spawn any in. So if I go and do loads here, I won't do that. That's a little bit mean. That could have been a good tactic, because that would mean that Squid can't get any dogs, because there's like a certain amount of dogs that can be in the world. So if I just stole them all, he wouldn't be able to get any. But I know you can have lots of dogs. I think you can have up to like about 20 or so dogs. So I'm not stealing too many here. Right, so let's just see the shape of the dog. They kind of go a little bit bigger at the front there. Okay, let's try and do this. Let's go and try and add in the collar, shall we? So I guess the collar would actually kind of be going like this. And oh, hello! Hello, it's a little puppy dog as well. That is so cute. Right, let's go and do the collar. First, shall we? Going around the outside here. And normally the head kind of goes a little bit smaller. Actually, I could make the head maybe a little bit thinner, as you know, because then the head is just going to be ridiculously small. So let's just make the head like this, and then you'll see the collar around the outside. And as I said, I don't want to spend too long on this, because I will just run out of time. So I need to go and add in the nose. I can't do the nose in the middle, really, because of the dimensions. Well, tell you what, let's make this all a little bit wider then, shall we? I think to kind of save this design, I'm going to have to make the legs go a little bit wider on this side here. So if I go like this, then that way at least I can have a middle, and then the nose and then the eyes won't be wonky. And I know I don't want to spend too much time on this, but if it looks bad, you know, if it just looks stupid, then it'll end up being worse than, you know, kind of just not doing it at all. So if I go like this, and then I guess I should probably go one higher as well, so all of the dimensions go and kind of add up. So there we go. This is looking okay now. And so there's the nose sticking out there. I guess I should make the nose stick out a little bit further, and it's kind of a bit pinky. They're gonna have pinky noses. I guess I could use stained clay. This is the white stained clay is actually a pretty similar color to what their noses are. So if I kind of go like this and like this as well, then I can do the little nose bit on the top there. That's looking pretty good. And then I can do the mouth as well. And I think I'll use wool for this. If I use dark gray wool, I think this will kind of match a little bit like what the mouths are like. There we go. That's looking pretty decent. And then this pattern kind of goes a little bit around here as well, like this. So if I go and fill it all in with this color there, like that. And then I'm going to add the eyes in, which are, of course, just some kind of normal black eyes. And where would they be? I think I've done the nose a little bit too high, actually. So if I just go and move this all down, I think this is going to look a little bit better. So I've already spent a little bit too long on this statue than I wanted to. But I think, ultimately, it's going to be worth it. Because I think this looks pretty good. I think this looks like a pretty nice statue. And there we go. Here is Barnaby. Of course, it's missing its ears, which I can go and add on there like that. And there we go. That looks like a pretty nice doggy. So now let's go and do the body. So the body's going to be a bit small. It's going to be a bit of a weird shape. But that's okay, because it's a statue. It doesn't need to be realistic looking. It can be kind of like, I guess it's going to look a little bit like a puppy, I guess. So it can be a stylized, wacky, cartoony version of Barnaby. So let's go and let's make this a little bit lower, and then let's make the body a little bit smaller than the collar and the head, and then I can go and just add a tail in. I kind of go, if I go like down to the side a little bit, I can kind of go down like that, and there we go. There's the doggy's tail, and it's kind of got a little bit of a gap here, so let's go and fill this in. So I did spend a lot more time on the statue than I wanted to, but I think it looks okay. I think that looks pretty adorable. Is there anything else I can do to change the eyes? It's kind of like a whiter white around the eyes, and I think maybe quartz. Maybe if I did quartz like... Let me have another look. Oh, look, the eyes are right next to the nose, actually. So let's go and do the eyes, maybe a little bit lower. Oh, actually, that looks cute. I'm going to leave it like that. That looks absolutely adorable. There is my doggy. And I might maybe just add some light gray around the ears as well, because the ears do look a little bit strange. So maybe I could add some white gray like here on them, maybe, or make them maybe I did the light gray there and then did it like that. Does that look better? No, actually, I'm just gonna leave it as it was. That is fine. Right, let's go and get some other things done then, shall we? So I kind of want this area to kind of be to be fenced off a little bit. So let's go and build around this, and I'm going to alternate between the these and these. So I got the normal stone bricks, and then this one with the cool pattern as well. So I'm going to do this around the outside, and then I can kind of do some fences around here as well. I'm going to do some cobblestone fences, kind of just marking off this area like this. So I then need to go boom, boom, and boom, like that. And there we go. This seems to line up perfectly. And excuse me, doggy, little puppy, you can go and fall down there. And then let's go and do this. So this is the statue, which is going to be in the center of my doggy park. And now I think I'm going to work on, I could do some paths and things. I want to have a nice path that you can go and walk around to get around the doggy park. So let's do, what don't I build out of much? Let's do gravel. I can't imagine the last time I properly built using gravel. So let's go and do a gravel park path that can be going around the entire park. So if I kind of go forward along here, as so people can go and admire the statue, and then I can sort of go around the outside here. I do have a lot of dogs in my in my way around here, but of course the most important thing about a dog park is the dogs. So I need to make sure I do have them. But then I can do kind of a path, which will be like a bit of a trail around here, and I don't want it to be like perfect. I can kind of go back and forth a little bit like this, and then there's the other thing. So I wanted a bath. I want a doggy bath. I want like a pond that they can go and swim in. I want the trail where they need to go and try and dig up bones that have been hidden under the ground, and then maybe like kind of just a better dog walking or dog training area, or maybe some doggy games, like a doggy playpen. That would be quite cool. I don't have a huge amount of room here, to be honest. It's quite good because I'm not really going to be building anything big. I can just spend a lot of time now just doing all of the little details, and I think this has been quite a nice start already. So there we go. Here's the path going around the absolutely adorable statue, which is in the middle here. I am very happy with how that looks. So let's go and just add some trees in then, shall we? Let's go and add some trees into the park here. So I'm just going to go and throw a bunch of these around the outside of this area here. And then I can just go and use a bone meal to try and make them all grow. But I'm going to leave a gap here because I think this might be where I'm going to go and put the pond down. So let's go and get the pond down because some of those trees kind of might just grow anyway just while I'm building this. So this can be the doggy bath spa, maybe. That's what this area can be here. And it's basically just going to be a pond. So if I just go two blocks down, then that way you can see that we're still going to see the grass and the dirt under the water rather than the ugly bedrock, which would be further down there. So I can go a little bit like this. I can actually move the path a little bit further this way, and then that way I can kind of have a little bit of a bigger pond, because the statue in the path did take up quite a lot of room. So let's go and break this way away a little bit, just like that, and I'll go and put that block there, and so then I can have the pond a little bit wider, and I can put some lily pads in there maybe, and then that's just going to be a nice place for the dogs to do some swimming. They can go and do the doggy paddle, I guess. But I probably should have actually done some areas for me to be able to place the water, and if I fill it in like this, is there going to be horrible streams? Oh nope, there are. Alright, if I just go and build over the top like this, I can go and just place the water on the underneath, then that way the water should hopefully all level out. I think I need to do a little bit more down this way. It really annoys me when the water's going all crazy. I think a little bit more on this area here, maybe. Can I place it around the outside? Is that going to get rid of it? Nope. I think I need to do some along here. If I go and fill in all of this with water, I think I've made my pond a nice, smooth, and level pond. And oh no, I nearly have. There's a few gaps where it's streaming, but you know what? I really do not have time to worry about it. So for once, I'm going to have to just leave it the way it is. And let's put some lily pads in. And the dogs are still going to have fun swimming around in it. Right, let's go and get these trees grown, because I think that's going to make a big difference. And I can also go and just put the bone meal all over the ground like this. So that then that way we go. Oh, no, no. Oh, no, I'm sorry, cow. No, get out of there. No, get out of there. Woo. That was dangerous. I nearly killed the cow by a tree growing through it. Who knew that that could be so dangerous? there we go. I was able to save its life, though. So yeah, here we go. Let's go and grow all of these, and I can keep putting tall grass just to make it feel more like a park. You kind of want lots of long grass everywhere, and I've kind of grown myself into a tree there. Who knew how dangerous these trees could actually be? Is this one going to grow? Are you going to grow? Yep, it just about grew there, and it's growing all over the path, and that's okay. It just makes it feel a little bit more wild. order, I guess. So let's go and do another tree there, and I can put some tall grass all the way around here and around the statue as well. And of course, I've got all of my dogs everywhere. And now let's do the bone hunt trail, shall we? So I guess I need something to mark where the bones are going to be. Or I guess I could just go and hide the bones. I could hide them in item frames, maybe. Because otherwise, if I just throw them down there, then they're going to disappear. So if I just kind of dig down in places and put them under the ground here, I guess if I do it like... If I do it just so it's just one block under the ground like that, and then this can be a part of the bone hunt. I feel like I need to mark them with something slightly different than just the normal grass. If I put gravel down, will the item frame hold it up? No, it won't, but it doesn't destroy it either. Look, if I do that, I can dig and then, oh, okay, maybe it does destroy. Let me go and test this again. If I just put this gravel down here, does it destroy the item frame? And oh, it does, but it takes a little bit of time. Okay, so I can't use gravel then, but there's got to be something else. Soul sand, I think soul sand might drop. I guess soul sand looks a little bit like mud, maybe. So I think that might be okay. So let's go, let's put that back down there, and then let's do this, and then put the bone in there, and then the soul sand on top. And so these are all of the places where the dogs can go and try and dig up the different bones as part of the bone hunt. I'm trying to think that if I was a dog, I try to think of all of the things that I like and then trying to have all of those things. Oh, I should do something with pork chops maybe as well, because dogs absolutely love pork chops. I know certainly Barnaby does. So I could maybe do like a pork chop vending machine. I'm sure that the doggies would like that. So I have both of their favorite food. I got a cool statue and I have a place for them to play in the pond. I think if I was a dog, this would be certainly a park that I would like to visit. So let's go and place this down here. And I think I'll do one more maybe down in this area here, and I'll go and hide the bone underneath there. And then let's try and do like maybe a pork chop vendor or something maybe, if I have time. Let's just try and build something very quickly down here. I'll do it out of pink wool. And I could have a pink as well. I could have a pink wool and then a pig selling some pork chops here. Even though that's a little bit ridiculous with a pig selling them, I think it's quite funny, and I think a good way to hopefully win votes is to try and do something funny. So that is going to be my very quick shack here. I have to be extremely quick because I literally have about 1 minute left. So let's go and build a little roof on this place here. I need to go and put a pig inside as well. So if I put just some fence poles on the front here, then that way the pig won't escape. And I could make this a little bit bigger, actually. If I go and just extend this out and let me go and grab some fences, it literally does not matter what it's made out of. Let's go out to here, and I could maybe do like that. And then if I go and I put pink wool under here as well, because that looks a bit weird, then I could put pressure plates on the top to make it kind of look a little bit more like a table, I guess. So let's go and get some pressure plates and put them down the top here like this. Then I can go and spawn in my pig, and I can go and put him away in the piggy pen. And I need to be extremely fast here though. So where are the spawn eggs? I need to get the spawn eggs. Here they are. Let's just go and put a pig in here. So he is selling some pork chops, because that is kind of crazy. And let's go and actually get some pork chops then, shall we? I can put them at the back here and all the way along the top here. And then I guess I just need some leads as well, would be good. So let's see if I can very quickly go and put down some leads in an item frame before I run out of time. I've only got about 5 seconds left though, so I need to be really fast. Where are the leads? Let's just go boom, 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 and boom, and there we go. Time is up. So let me unmute my microphone, and then I can go and talk to Squid, and I can see how well he did. Hello?
Mate, I didn't press my timer, so I didn't know.
Oh, well, that was timing just ended.
Yeah, I listened to you, and I was like, I was waiting for him to stop. So,
man, that
was
intense. That was absolutely perfect timing then, though.
Oh, dear. Oh, man, how did you do?
I think I did quite well. I'm happy. I'm happy. Whether I win or lose, I am happy with what I built today. You'll see.
Okay.
How about you? You feeling confident?
Yeah, I don't know. Sort of. I mean, I didn't really have a timer, so it was really weird. I didn't really feel that much pressure. I was just kind of building until I had to stop. So, yeah, let's burn the wall. Let's do it. Let's see what each other has built.
Burn the wall!
Burn the wall!
Burn the wall. Oh, I'm a little bit scared. I got trees close to the wall here, so I'm keeping a close eye. I don't want my park to burn down.
No, me neither. All right, okay. Let's just put out the fire.
Oh no! I can hear dogs burning.
Okay, them dogs haven't really followed me.
Oh.
Just sit down. This is a doggy park.
Okay. I nearly killed a cow in my go as well because I planted a tree and then it grew through a cow and I had to save the cow's life. It's been a dangerous build. Right, do you want to start off showing yours?
Yeah, let's have a look at my... Oh, your tree's on fire, mate.
Is it? Oh, no. No, stop this. Stop this. Help me, Squid. Stop watching and laughing. Help me out. No.
Stop building stamps. Stamps, stop there building.
Oh, this doesn't count.
This counts.
Can I come... No, am I allowed to get rid of the water?
Yeah, you can get rid of the water.
Oh, I didn't think about adding a fountain in, actually. I might leave it. Oh, okay, wait, imagine these trees weren't burnt to a crisp. You've got to use your imagination on this bit.
Okay, right, you ready?
Yeah, do you want to show me around yours?
So this is my doggy park.
This is nice.
Yep. I got the inspiration from my dogs, okay? So, you know, I've got two dogs. This is Lily. So it's a beagle, so I did it her colours. And then this is me. It's not Billy. It's definitely not Billy. It's me. And then this is Marley. I really like how
Marley's this is your hand.
Yeah.
I was like, what's that bit?
Yeah, it's like, that's the hand. I'm like patting him on the head.
Is that a pimple or something? Like from here, I can't see it's your hand. From here it makes sense.
And then, yeah, like a tennis ball. Got a nice little fountain in the corner. There's a bit where the dogs can go under. And then I got some logs over here so they can jump over them and go... And that's it.
So are these like miniature dogs then?
Yeah, I mean like... Because I tried to build, the dogs the same size as, you know, the rest of the surroundings, but it just didn't work. Like, you can't put that much detail, into them, so it didn't really work out. It looked weird. So,
And what breed of dog is this one?
That's the famous horse hoof breed.
Horse hoof breed?
Yeah. Yeah, it's a very rare one. You don't really see many nowadays. Many people get them confused with horses, which is really weird, but I tell them it's completely different.
No, it's understandable, actually.
Yeah, no, it's completely different stamps. They're actually a breed of dogs, so, yeah.
they're just exactly like horses, but they bark. That's what it is.
pretty much.
Right then, so this is my one. Okay. So, I've got to get rid of this water. Look at this. It looks like it was so lovely. It was so nice and tidy. And then there we go. I think it's going away. So these are all the dogs that are here. And,
why is this saw sand?
I see you're a dog lover. See, this is the bone trail. You see, there's hidden bones all over the park, and so you can dig if you dig them up, you can discover that there's bones hidden underneath.
That's
you see,
cool.
Which dogs like to do. There's a lead here, which you probably listened to me placing at the very last second to take the doggies for a walk, and you can take them for a walk around this path here,
very
just
nice.
Like this. Lots of bones to dig up. This is the pork chop salesman. Because dogs love pork chops.
What is going? Is this the back end of a pig? It's just a box.
This is just a stand. This is just a stand.
Okay, I'm overthinking.
Funny enough, the pig went into the business of selling pork chops.
That's very weird. that's so weird. I'm not even going to question that.
don't think about it too much.
No,
and then
this is
a big statue of my favorite dog Barnaby when he was a puppy,
very
a chubby
nice.
Little puppy.
Very nice.
It's like one of those little figures that you always get. It's like one of them of Barnaby. What are they called? The pop figures.
Pop vinyl figures.
It's like a pop figure of Barnaby. That's what this is.
Oh man. Yeah, cool. Very nice builds, mate. Very nice builds. I'm gonna say we're not very similar, but it is kind of similar again, isn't it? But
they're a little bit. They're a little bit.
Little bit different.
They're both dog parks.
Yeah, at the end of the day, that matters.
They're both dog parks. But you know what will be different, Squid?
The votes.
Probably. And also,
more
next
votes.
Week's going to be different, isn't it, Squid?
Yes, Stamps, it is. Do you want to explain why?
Yeah, I'll try to. So we decided to shake things up a little bit. So for next week only, instead of doing one build each for 15 minutes, We are going to do three builds that are going to be 5 minutes long.
Oh.
Okay. So there's going to be three sections that they're going to be smaller than this. Each box will be about a third of the size of this build area, but we only have 5 minutes to build. So when you're suggesting a topic for next week, you need to suggest three different themes, but they all need to be things that we can build quite quickly. So don't suggest like build New York, because we can't build New York in five minutes. So
we need to suggest
three topics, and they can be slightly related if you want, but they don't have to be. So that's what you need to do if you want to suggest topics for next week. And I guess for the votes, you just vote for who built the best three builds. You're not going to have to vote for each one separately.
Yeah. Okay, cool. I hope everyone got that and it's not too confusing.
So basically, you need to suggest three topics rather than one. It couldn't be simpler. But also, we want you to vote on this week. So you can vote in the same way. If you haven't seen the past episodes, the way you do it is either click a link in the description. One says vote for Squid and one says vote for Stampy. Or in the top right corner of the screen, there should be a little icon. And if you click on that, a little drop down menu will come. And you can once again click on either vote for Squid or vote for Stampy.
So anyway, guys, that is the end of Building Time for this week. Hope you have enjoyed. We'll be back next Friday for another awesome episode. Thanks for watching. See you all then. Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye.